If you're interested in learning about the founder of the first newspaper or newspaper in America to be published by and for Black women, then my Josephine St. Pierre Ruffin Black History Short is for you. Hi, and thank you for tuning in to Noir Histoire. I'm Natasha, and in this episode, I'll be sharing what I've learned about Josephine St. Pierre Ruffin, born on August 31st, 1842, died on March 13th, 1924, notable publisher and activist. Nationality, American. Josephine St. Pierre was born into a prominent family in Boston's small Black Beacon Hill neighborhood. Her mother, Elizabeth Matilda Menahick, was a white Englishwoman, while her father, John St. Pierre, was from Martinique. He was of French and African heritage and had founded the Boston Zion Church. As a child, she was raised in an environment that was immersed in the abolitionist cause and championed equality. It's worth noting that at a time when a lot of females were not formally educated, St. Pierre attended school in Boston and was also sent to Salem as the schools there had been integrated. At 16 years old, St. Pierre married George Lewis Ruffin, who was the first Black person to graduate from Harvard Law School. He later became Boston's first Black municipal judge and also served on the city council. Their marriage produced 5 children, consisting of 1 daughter and 4 sons. Unfortunately, one of the boys died in infancy, but the other children went on to become successful professionals as adults. Ruffin continued her education with some time in a finishing school and a few years studying with a private tutor in New York. But the Civil War began when Ruffin was 18 years old. She participated in the war effort by helping to recruit Black soldiers for the 54th and 55th Massachusetts Regiment and worked for the United States Sanitary Commission. After the war, she contributed to causes and organizations that aimed to address the needs of the newly freed Black people in the South. During the war, Ruffin had become involved with charity work and social justice causes related to the Black community and women's rights. Her participation in the women's suffrage movement required working with both Black and white activists and organizations. Moving between these communities, she helped to promote the need for women's rights in general, but also the particular issues standing in the way of progress for Black women. Her work on these campaigns and within these organizations brought her into contact with many of the prominent suffragists of the time. Ruffin's husband, who was 8 years her senior, died relatively young in 1886 at the age of 52. By this point, Ruffin had been involved with charities and activist organizations for several years. In the 1870s, she had become a writer for a weekly Black newspaper and was a member of the New England Women's Press Association. She became even more active after her husband's passing, no longer being just a member of organizations, but now founding her own. 4 years after her husband's death, Ruffin co-founded Women's Era with her daughter Florida. The newspaper was the first of its kind as it was published by and for Black women. Ruffin served as the paper's publisher, but co-edited with her daughter. Together, they used the paper to motivate and encourage Black women to become more involved with social justice initiatives, with a particular focus on women's and civil rights. As a companion to the newspaper, the pair joined with a local school principal, Maria Baldwin, to establish a local Women's Era club. They later held a convention that was attended by women from clubs across the country. This led to the creation of the National Federation of Afro-Am Women, which later merged with the Colored Women's League of Washington to form the National Association of Colored Women, the NAACP. With the creation of this new organization, Mary Church Terrell became president, and Ruffin became the first vice president. The women's club movement was very active at this time, but many clubs that had been organized by white women did not accept Black women as members. Ruffin had continued to be active in other social justice and women's suffrage clubs, becoming the first Black member of a few. But she was mistreated at a large convention for women's clubs that was held in Milwaukee, Wisconsin in 1900. As a representative of 3 organizations, Ruffin had bona fide credentials to attend the event. Yet when she arrived, Southern white women who had positions of authority within the organizing body refused to acknowledge her credentials and refused her entry. Some went so far as to attempt to forcefully remove her membership badge. When she was later offered entry, she declined based on what had occurred and because some other non-white women had also been turned away. The fiasco would be referred to as the Ruffin incident. The New Era Club ceased to function in 1903, but Ruffin remained involved with clubs and organizations, helping to co-found the Boston chapter of the NAACP and the League of Women for Community Service. She remained active right up until her death from nephritis at the age of 81 years old. Thanks for tuning in. Show notes and sources are available on the Noir Histoire website via the link in the episode description. I've created some downloadables and infographics, so check them out on the show notes page. These Black History Shorts are released every Tuesday, so if you enjoyed this episode and want more, subscribe to the channel, click the notification bell, and check out my Black History Shorts playlist.